Hey guys, it's Helen. Hope you guys are doing great. So today I just thought to come on and talk about being a self-taught musician or guitarist. But before we start, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please make sure you do, and don't forget to turn on that notification button. Yeah, click it. Thank you guys. Being a self-taught guitarist, is it possible? Of course it is. It has been done countless times. Is it easy? Not really, but it depends on how you see it. I've taught myself for a long time, so I know how it feels. And one of the challenges of being self-taught is that you're not accountable to anybody. You don't have anybody looking out for you in your guitar life and stuff. You don't have feedback from anybody. So you don't have a strategy, you don't have a plan, you don't have a focus, anything goes. And that can lead to a lot of wasted effort and time. A lot of motivation, a lot of encouragement will have to come from you because there's nobody helping you with that. I'm just going to share with you some things that I think that you can do that can help in, you know, saving time and just easing the process. Which leads me to my first point. Get significantly good at something first before moving to the next. You know that saying that you have to crawl before you can walk and then run? I think that that is true in learning any skill. There is a process and you have to follow it. This will help you avoid years of wasted effort and time. Also help you avoid picking up bad habits along the way, especially technique that is very hard to drop. It has happened to me and I'm still paying for it. There is so much information on the internet these days. It can also be overwhelming because there's so much to learn, like just drowning in the information. One thing I would say is if you're learning a lesson, finish it. If you're learning a song, finish it. Whatever you're learning, perfect it. Get significantly good at it before moving to something else. People, especially beginners, want to learn everything at the same time. It's not possible. You kind of want to learn the modes without already learning how to play like the major scale or the pentatonic scale. If you're learning to play the blues, who are your favorite blues players? Learn how they play or their vocabulary. Learn the concepts behind the blues, the scales, the key things that you hear in blues, and then you see a pattern that you can apply to your own personal playing. Second point, use technology to your advantage. There's an app for almost everything now. We're in a cool generation right now where we can learn anything we want just like this. Like, we're not in the 50s or in the 40s where they had to sweat to get anything or to learn anything. Now at your disposal you have like free courses and some paid ones, free apps. You have YouTube, Google, Facebook, you have Instagram. Oh my god, we have all of the tools available to us. Free tutorials from awesome people. I mean, if you're a beginner, you know Martin Music, you know Andy Guitar, you know Justin Guitar, and for like intermediate to advanced stuff, Rick Beato, Streetwise Guitar, Rick Graham, Music Is Win, so many others. You know them, just name them, or you can name them in the comment section. They are like apps that can help you slow down songs so that you can hear them well. I don't like using those apps because I have to install them on my phone, and when I'm using them I could get a message and it's kind of distracting. So what I use instead is this pedal. It's called the Vidami Pedal. It slows down any video on YouTube. You can loop a section of any video. While looping, you can slow it down and then you move on when you've gotten that part. You're not distracted and you don't have to touch your computer or anything. You just put this on the floor, plug it into your computer, and you're good to go. You can use this pedal to transcribe the songs yourself and train your ears. I have a 10% discount on the Vidami pedal if you want to purchase it. They are great teachers on YouTube. YouTube is here for you to learn. Take advantage of it. My third point will be develop a consistent practice schedule. We cannot really overemphasize the importance of consistent practice. Nobody's saying that you should practice for a gazillion hours a day, But even if it's like 30 minutes a day, 1 hour a day, make it count. Quality over quantity. Make sure that your practice schedule is focused, like I said before, it's deliberate, and you get something out of it. Practice slowly and get everything right, especially technique, vibrato, bends. Those are the things that make the guitar sound like the guitar, and that is why it's distinct to the guitar. I made those mistakes and it really affected me for a long time. My next tip would be keep yourself motivated by learning what you love. You're going to get drowned in the exercises and the technique and everything, but at the same time you want to be happy with yourself. Every once in a while, just ditch all the boring stuff. Learn your favorite songs. What inspired you to play the guitar? What are the songs that you like to sing? Play them, sing them. You can even do like your own versions of the song. You want to keep yourself motivated and inspired. The next tip would be work on your timing. Music is all about timing and moving to time. There is such a thing as playing outside of the time, but that is deliberately, and it's a thing. When you practice, always try to use a metronome or a backing track, especially if you're going to be playing with other people. You can record yourself to hear how you sound. You want to make sure that your time is on point, because it's really easy to get fast, you want to get better, and you're not playing to time. That is not a good place for a musician to be in. My next tip would be don't neglect music theory. I say this all the time because it's important. It deals with the whys, the hows, the whats, the behind the scenes stuff. It doesn't even have to be complex stuff, just basic music theory will be very beneficial to you, especially if you are looking to enhance, if you're looking to go far, why certain things sound better together than others. Music theory is kind of like a guide to help you with that. My last tip would be make your guitar accessible to you at all times. That means that you want to keep your guitar where you can see it often. When you wake up, it's probably by your bedside. It's not inside the bag, or it's not in the case. Bring it out, put it somewhere so it can be looking at you and make you feel guilty. Put it somewhere where when you see it, it's just screaming for you to pick it up. So that tremendously helps. A lot of people don't know. Have people of like minds that you can connect with or share with. So if you have like a guitar group that you can join, or a guitar community or something, that's very helpful. It's just, it's encouraging and it's motivating to know that you're not alone and there are other people that are going through the same thing that you're going to, that you're going through too. If you have access to a teacher, it would be advisable to get one. It could be online. It's always nice to have someone that you're accountable to, someone that can watch out for you, that can track your progress, that can evaluate you. Getting a teacher is really, really good. If you can, sure, but if you can't, of course you can do it on your own. Yeah. I also want to tell you that I am on Patreon. If you want to support what I do, I have exclusive content on Patreon. I'll leave a link up here or in the description. Please check it out and join if you want. Thank you guys for watching and keep pushing. Bye.